Switch software version 5.0 was already a little bit of a disappointment because it didn't offer any of the big features that a lot of people were expecting, but it also introduced some new problems for the console. Hello everybody, Gabe from Switch Force here, and Switch owners are saying that third-party docks and even charging units are bricking their consoles, and now Nintendo has commented on it for the first time, so we want to talk a little bit about it here. More of a PSA to let you know if you do have third-party docks and you do used a battery pack for your Switch an awful lot, you might want to stop. One of the major culprits here is the Nyko Switch dock, where you can go and get a dock for much less money than an official Nintendo dock, and if you have multiple TVs in your household and you want to just take your Switch from one to the other without having to move the dock and disconnect the HDMI cable from your home entertainment system, things of that nature, that is why people are getting these docks that are third party. They are cheaper. So that is kind of starting to cause people. There are a lot of users that are reporting their consoles being bricked. And look, it's a huge inconvenience, A, and B, a lot of people are losing their save file. User Sean G says that his 80-hour Zelda Breath of the Wild file no longer exists along with all the other content on the Nintendo Switch. Man, I would hate for that to happen. As someone who did lose a bunch of Zelda Breath of the Wild save footage, not because my console got bricked, my console is fine, but I totally relate to that. And Nintendo now kind of has addressed this. They say, quote, unlicensed products and accessories do not undergo Nintendo testing and evaluation process. They might not work at all with our game systems, and they could have compatibility problems with certain games, the Nintendo Switch system itself, or other licensed accessories and peripherals. So basically, Nintendo's kind of washing their hands of this. They're saying, hey, those are not official Nintendo products. We cannot endorse those. We have no control. So that's kind of what Nintendo's saying, but honestly, Nyko and other third-party manufacturers need to do something about this. They gotta do more testing. It's like really unfair that, you know, you're selling a product such as the Nyko dock, and you know, a customer goes and buys it and it completely messes up their console. Yes, Nyko is like fixing it and they're replacing the Switch if it needs to happen, but the damage is already done, especially with those save files. That is something huge. We have also seen Reddit users that claim that using battery banks is kind of messing with their Switch unit as well. So if we're being honest at this point, me, I'm not going to use anything that isn't officially Nintendo. I do not want to lose all my saves. I do not want to have to re-download the many, many, many games I have on Switch. That's not something I want to go through. And I honestly can't afford to have my Switch not working for a week or two while it gets fixed or RMA'd or whatever be the case. Let me know if you guys have one of these third-party docks in the comments below. Have you guys had any problems, or do you know anyone that has had any problems? This kind of just serves as a PSA. You know, Kotaku does have the article with much more information. I'll go ahead and link that in the description below. You guys can check that out. So let me know if you guys enjoyed the content here. Hit the thumbs up. If you did, don't forget to subscribe. Hit that notification bell so that you don't miss any of our future content. You guys are awesome, and we appreciate you a whole lot. Thank you for watching. Switch Force out.